Okay, welcome to the 2025 giant pumpkin growing season. I'm only a few weeks after the last weigh off at Half Moon Bay, where I weighed in my 2,465 pound pumpkin, which was a heck of an accomplishment. In a later video, I'll talk about what goals I'll set for 2025. But to get things kicked off, the main thing that needs to happen right now is getting the patch prepared for winter. And sort of the number one goal right now is to get roots in the ground in the form of a cover crop. And this period of time right now, late October, is a really good time to do that because you have a little bit of time, still enough light in the day to establish some plant before you get into what's called the Persephone period, where, you know, usually when you're below 10 hours of daylight per day, you know, your plants will survive if you pick the right variety, but they really don't grow much. So you want to get some amount of plant, some amount of root established before you hit that period, you know, sort of late November. And then they'll pick back up in February, mid-February, at least in my latitude. So before I do that, the most important thing that I want to do is take a soil test again and see what I'm left with in terms of nutrient levels and organic matter and the pH level that's in the soil. And so I have a pretty good idea of what I would expect, but with the pumpkins growing, plants growing all year long, they've obviously consumed and changed the overall soil level. So I want to see where it's at. And then I really won't react to all the nutrient level type stuff, but I would react to two things. pH level, if the pH is moved away from where is ideal, I will make an adjustment to that before I plant the cover crop, before winter. And then the second is organic matter, which is usually in the form of compost. So I'll look at that organic matter percent. And then everything else I'll take note of, all the micro and macronutrients I'll take note of, but I won't make adjustments to those things until the springtime. So what I did today, and I've shown videos in the past doing this, I went out here in the patch and then took samples in probably 12 to 15 different locations. And then I put those samples in the bucket here and mix them all up, take out any dirt clods or big, you know, chunks of anything, any organic material. And then I take out a sample from that bucket of it all mixed up into this bag, and then I send it off to the lab. If you want to see a more detailed version of that, you can look at, I think it was the first episode of the 2024 growing season. I kind of went in a little more detail. So I'll send those this test out, and in a week or so I'll have my results. Here are the results that I got back from the soil test. The two things that I'm going to look most closely at here in the winter time is, where is the pH at? Do I need to make any adjustments? And where is my organic matter percent, and how that relates to the cation exchange capacity? So first thing is, I know that my native soil, before I did anything, grew anything in this soil, my native soil has a pH of 6, which is on the low side. Last year I made an adjustment and I moved that all the way up to 7.2. So at the time of planting in 2024, my pH was 7.2. And you can see after the full season, it's rebounded a bit down, moving back down towards sort of that native soil level of 6. 6.9 isn't far enough for me to feel like I need to make any adjustments. So I'm okay with that. So no change to pH, but I am seeing that it is starting to rebound to the native soil pH level. Second thing I see is organic matter is at 3.4%. When I started the season in 2024, I had it up at 17. That was due to compost that I had added in the previous winter. So you can see that the organic matter has been consumed or moved throughout the soil and is reduced. So to go from 3.4, I want to bump that up a bit, not a ton. I think 17 is actually a little higher than we really need to target. But I think what I'm going to do is add about 2 cubic yards of compost per 1,000 square feet of patch growing area. And that's really all I'm going to do in the wintertime, and then of course plant a cover crop. But I'll take note of all these nutrient levels, and I have an idea of what I will do, you know, in the springtime. The reason I'm not going to make the nutrient adjustments in the winter is, you know, a lot of those things
are mobile and will move out of the soil, will get, you know, washed away with rain. So you can spend some money and add a bunch of these things, and then you retest in the spring and a lot of them have left. So it's my opinion, it's best to wait until the springtime to do your nutrient adjustments. But just as a quick note, I can really see, you know, really the season of growing the pumpkins in this patch has consumed a lot of these. So in the springtime when I started, you know, my calcium level was at 2,500. You can see now it's down to 1,200. My phosphorus number was at 54. It's now down to 14. You know, nitrogen was up above 18. Now it's down to 13. Potassium was well over 340. Now it's down to 230. So all of these things have moved, which is what you'd expect. But basically all of these values I've then input into the soil calculator, and with some help, I should say. And in the soil calculator, made some adjustments, you know, within the calculator to see sort of come spring, what adjustments will I need to make. Here is the soil calculator. So top left, I'm treating 1,000 square feet. Actually, I'm going to be treating 2,000 square feet, but per 1,000 square feet, this is what results I have. So all of the results from the soil test that I just showed you go in here, and then input the number of yards of compost that you plan to add. And I've actually got the compost input, the specific compost supplier that I'm using, input in here into the calculator. And I use the soil test from that compost company, so I know the exact input that compost brings in terms of other nutrients. And then that will adjust the ppm of a given nutrient or a given element, and that changes what you need to adjust. And then again, as a reminder, just I've gone through this before in previous videos, but the most important thing when you're making an adjustment to your soil is you're trying to balance this ratio. So this idealized ratio here is a good target. Or sorry, here's the ideal ratio here. This is my actual ratio. So there's some ranges, and it's pretty much impossible to get it perfect. And even the idealized ratio is just a best guess from, you know, other pumpkin growers and soil science folks. So down here, you can add, like for example, pelletized gypsum bumps up my low calcium number. And you can see calcium number here is low. Then don't forget there's some calcium in the compost, so that adjusts it a bit. And then the calcium that is added here shows what your NPPM will be. And then anything with calcium in here, its ratio relative to the other element that is in that ratio is going to adjust. So it's kind of a little bit of, you know, guess and check to get these numbers. And like I mentioned, I had a lot of help. You know, Cecil Weston is a big help to the pumpkin growing community. He's been helping me. I'm trying to learn as much as I can myself so I can be able to do this on my own. But he still is a really good resource and has some great videos on YouTube as well that I recommend checking out. All right, so now I just got to go get my compost and get my cover crop planted. All right, getting some fresh compost. So getting 10 yards dumped, but I'm only gonna use about 2 to 3 yards per 1,000 square feet on the existing patch based on my soil test and where the organic matter is. And then I'm gonna grow some more pumpkins over here. That's a fresh patch, I'll use a little bit more there, similar to what I did on the virgin ground last year.
I'm gonna use a little tractor, grab scoops of the compost here, make little piles in the patch out here, and then we'll rake them flat. Okay, I've got about 2 to 3 yards per 1,000 square feet spread over the existing pumpkin patch, the one I grew in this year. And then over here, I spread out a bunch of extra native soil that I had, and then I added a little bit more concentration of compost because this is the first time this patch is seeing any additional compost. This patch I'm just gonna spread cover crop seed directly on it. There's no need to till. Really don't need to till here. Only reason I'm gonna put a light till in is really just because I have a decent amount of weeds that were growing from the pumpkin growing year, and I just don't want them to seed. So I'm gonna break them up just pretty surface level, and then I'll spread the cover crop seed directly on that mixed up soil. And then pretty much it's just wait it out through the winter. Seed has been spread. I did a legume mix here, and then over there I did, I think, all vetch. And then in this space over here, which another 2,000 square feet, a little more than 2,000 square feet here, not planning to grow anything this year, but it could become a rotation, you know, two pumpkins here, two pumpkins there, and then rotate every other year, something like that. So I figured I'd put a cover crop down here, and I put winter rye here. So this will be winter rye. Perfect timing. So this is the day after I got this patch area prepared, and it's probably hard to tell on the camera, but it's raining. We'll get a half inch to an inch, and the ground's all wet right where all the cover crop seed has been put down. You can see the three different patch areas are getting a good soak. So I had to get it done yesterday, and the timing was perfect. Now just let it do its thing.